This is the Amazfit Stratos 3. It's a beautiful watch. It's got carbon fiber body to it, lots of different watch faces, and transflective screen. You can see it easy in reflected light, like sunlight. I put a different band on it, a metal band, than the TPU one that it came in, so I can use it as a dress watch. I just wanted to show you that capability is there. Where did we get this one? From Banggood. These guys have supplied us this sample for review, and we've got a full review up on it. So check out the review if you're interested in the watch, and check the show notes to see if you can get a buying link for this. It's just now coming in, so check to see its availability as well. But that's not why we're here today. We are here in this special video because this particular watch, and I presume new ones that will be coming out, have a different way of doing satellite connectivity to give you your location. This particular watch uses GPS, and it also uses, as you can see, GLONASS. It also can be set to use BeiDou and Galileo. And any of these that you want, you just simply slide over, say check, and it completely switched the antennas and electronics inside for acquiring your location on planet Earth to include both GPS and the other service. So what are the other services? That's what we're here today to talk about. First of all, from the product information sheet for this particular watch, they state that the integrated Sony GNSS chips support four different global positioning systems: GPS, GLONASS, BeiDou, and Galileo. Now, the reason I'm doing a video is because they're using an integrated Sony set of chips, which most likely means they're going to just start being dropped in all kinds of watches. And you're going to need to know which combination works in your area, right? So you can combine any two of them to form three different positioning patterns. By any two, it means GPS plus one of these other ones, which enhances the positioning, speed, and tracking accuracy. So here we go. Going over to Wikipedia, my friend, I am going to walk through this with you. First, we're going to discuss the global positioning system. Now, I'm just going to read this to you, so if you want to listen to my voice, that's great. Otherwise, if you want to read it, you can turn my voice off. Either way, we're going to get through this together. The global positioning system, GPS, originally called the Navistar GPS, is a satellite-based radio navigation system owned by the United States government and operated by the United States Space Force. That's the new force, remember? There was the Air Force, and then they spun off the Space Force, and so that's something new. It's actually been transferred to the Space Force. It is one of the global navigation satellite systems, so these all fall under the GNSS, that provide geolocation and time information to a GPS receiver anywhere on or near the Earth, where there is an unobstructed line of sight to four or more GPS satellites. And when you go in, you see all these reference numbers. You can drill down deeper to find out more background on all of this. So I highly encourage you to just go Wikipedia and put in GPS, for example. You'll get this information and more. Obstacles such as mountains and buildings block the relative weak GPS signals, as we've all encountered. The GPS does not require the user to transmit any data, and it operates independently of any telephonic or internet reception, which means you don't need to have your internet on in your watch to pick up your location. The GPS provides critical positioning capabilities to military, civil, and commercial users around the world. The United States government created the system, maintains it, and makes it freely accessible to anyone with a GPS receiver. Sounds pretty cool, huh? Let's keep going. The GPS service is provided by the United States government, which can selectively deny access to the system, as happened in the Indian military in 1999 during the Kargil War, or degrade the service at any time. As a result, several countries have developed or are in the process of setting up other global or regional satellite navigation systems. The Russian Global Navigation Satellite System, GLONASS, was developed contemporaneously, that's a big word, I love that one, contemporaneously with GPS, but suffered from incomplete coverage of the globe until the mid-2000s. GLONASS can be added to GPS devices, making more satellites available and enabling positions to be fixed more quickly and accurately to within 2 meters, or about 6.6 feet. China's BeiDou Navigation Satellite System began global services in 2018 with full deployment scheduled for 2020. And I'm making this video in June 2020. There are also the European Union Galileo Positioning System and India's NavIC. Japan's quasi-zenith satellite system is a GNSS satellite-based augmentation system to enhance GNSS's accuracy in Asia Oceania, with satellite navigation independent of GPS scheduled for 2023. Interesting. Well, when selective ability was lifted in 2000, GPS had about a 5 meter or 16 feet accuracy. The latest stage, get this, of accuracy enhancement uses the L5 band and is now fully deployed. GPS receivers released in 2018 that use the L5 band can have much higher accuracy, pinpointing to within 30 centimeters, or about 11.8 inches. That's less than a foot of accuracy. I don't think our watches are doing that yet. I'm happy if I can get on the left side of the street instead of the right side of the street when it shows me driving or biking. But nonetheless, the capability's there. So look for more improvements in the future. So now we're going to talk about combining GPS with these other services. First is the China system, BeiDou. I'm putting that one up first because these watches do come from China and they have their own navigation satellite system. So BeiDou is a Chinese satellite navigation system that consists of two separate satellite constellations. The first BeiDou system, officially called the BeiDou Satellite Navigation Experimental System, and also known as BeiDou 1. I'm sorry if I'm not pronouncing that right. I'm not really versed in English pronunciation of Chinese words. Consists of three satellites, which offered limited coverage and navigation services mainly for users in China and neighboring regions. BeiDou 1 was decommissioned at the end of 2012. Now, the second generation of the system, officially called BeiDou Navigation Satellite System, BDS, and also known as Compass or BeiDou 2, became operational in China in December of 2011 with partial constellations of 10 satellites in orbit. Now, since December 2012, it's been offering services to customers in the Asia-Pacific region. Are you there? Then you may want GPS plus BeiDou. In 2015, China launched the third generation BeiDou system, BeiDou 3, for global coverage. Oh, well, okay, not just China now. As of October 2018, 15 BDS-3 satellites have been launched. BeiDou 3 will eventually consist of 35 satellites and is expected to provide global services upon completion in 2020. Obviously, they need to update the article. Do we have 35 satellites? Is it fully operational? And how does it compare with GPS? Are they augmenting each other so that you can find any four satellites from either system to get a fix? Don't know yet. The official English name of the system is BeiDou Navigation Satellite System. It is named after, are you ready? The Big Dipper asterism, which is known in Chinese as that word. The name literally means Northern Dipper, the name given by ancient Chinese astronomers to the seven brightest stars in the Ursa Major constellation, which we call the Big Dipper here. Historically, this set of stars was used in navigation to locate the North Star. As such, the name BeiDou also serves as a metaphor for the purpose of the satellite navigation system. Okay, so we have GPS with all sorts of capabilities and accuracy down to under a foot. And now it looks like in 2020, we have a fully operational BeiDou 3 with 35 satellites up there. So on your watch, when you come in here and you select in location services, GPS plus BeiDou, you're getting the benefit of both of those because receiver in here will pick up either of them. But wait, there's more. Enter Russia. Now we have the GLONASS system. GLONASS is a global navigation satellite system providing real-time position and velocity determination for military and civilian uses. The satellites are located in middle circular orbit at 19,100 kilometers, about 19,900 miles altitude, with a 64.8 degree inclination in a period of 11 hours and 15 minutes, more than you want to know. However, it's important to know where on Earth it is and whether you'll be able to pick it up. GLONASS's orbit makes it especially suited for usage in high latitudes, north or south, where getting a GPS signal can be problematic. The constellation operates in three orbital planes with eight evenly spaced satellites on each. A fully operational constellation with global coverage consists of 24 satellites, while 18 satellites are necessary for coverage, covering the territory of Russia. To get the position fix, the receiver must be in the range of at least four satellites. So we're looking at global GPS plus GLONASS if you're above or below 64.8 degrees. Straight up is 90 degrees, right? North Pole, equator's at zero, 45 is mid. So this is pretty far up there, or pretty far down there. Antarctica, Greenland, northern Russia, all of those things. Manufacturers of GPS navigation devices say that adding GLONASS makes more satellites available to them, meaning positions can be fixed more quickly and accurately, especially in built-up areas where buildings may obscure the view of some GPS satellites. GLONASS supplementation of GPS systems also improves positioning in high latitudes, north or south. So, if you're in that situation, you switch to GPS plus GLONASS. You got it made. Now, the final one, and this is the newest one, Galileo. Are you ready for this? Welcome to the European Union. So, Galileo is the global navigation satellite system that went live in 2016, created by the European Union through the European GNSS agency. It's a £10 million project, is named after the Italian astronomer Galileo Galilei. One of the aims of Galileo is to provide an independent, that's an important word as you'll find out in this article, high precision positioning system so European nations do not have to rely on the US GPS or the Russian GLONASS systems, which could be disabled or degraded by their operators at any time. The use of basic low-precision Galileo services is free and open to everyone. The higher precision capabilities are available for paying commercial users. Galileo is intended to provide horizontal and vertical, that's going to be your altitude now, position measurements within 1 meter, 3 feet precision. The best positioning services at higher latitudes than other positioning systems. So it also is good way up or way down on the Earth. Galileo is also to provide a new global search and rescue function as part of their MEOSAR system, which there's a click through if you want to learn more about that. Galileo is intended to be an EU civilian GNSS that allows all users access to it. Initially, GPS reserved the highest quality signal for military use, and the signal available for civilian use was intentionally degraded. It was called selective availability. This changed with President Bill Clinton signing a policy directive in 1996 to turn off selective availability. Since May 2000, the same precision signal has been provided to both civilian and military. And as we learned earlier in GPS, that's down to within 11.8 inches, or about 1 foot, right? Since Galileo was designed to provide the highest possible precision, which is greater than GPS, actually, to anyone, well, the U.S. was concerned that an enemy could use Galileo signals in military strikes against the U.S. and its allies. Yep, some weapons like missiles use GNSSs for guidance. The frequency initially chosen for Galileo would have made it impossible for the U.S. to block the Galileo signals without also interfering with its own GPS signals. The U.S. did not want to lose their GNSS capability with GPS, while at the same time denying enemies the use of GNSS. Yeah, some U.S. officials became especially concerned when Chinese interest in Galileo was supported. Here we go. This is from Wikipedia. I don't like getting political on this channel, and I am not. I'm simply reading a page, okay? Check it out on your own if you want to go there. But I think this is really interesting background information as these watches start to integrate all these systems together. An anonymous, now really follow this thread, an anonymous EU official claimed that the US officials implied, so we have an anonymous person talking about somebody implying that they might consider shooting down Galileo satellites in the event of a major conflict in which Galileo was used in attacks against American forces. Aya. How do you spell Aya? The EU's Aya stance is that Galileo is a neutral technology available to all countries and everyone. We're not picking favorites. At first, EU officials did not want to change their original plans for Galileo, but they have since reached the compromise that Galileo is to use different frequencies. This allows the blocking or jamming of either GNSS without affecting the other. So what does that mean for your watch? Well, if you're in here and you switch it to GPS plus Galileo, if GPS is blocked, you got Galileo. If Galileo is blocked, you got GPS. And if both of them are blocked, you can back up to BeiDou or GLONASS. Welcome to a new world where you know where you are on planet Earth, no matter what part of the planet you're on, or no matter who's cooperating or not cooperating at the time. That's the new technology. That's what's come out in the brand new Stratos 3, which is available right now, and you can pick it up. Of course, we need to have a sponsor for this one from Banggood. The Stratos 3, you've seen the full review of it, got all of the different GPS satellite type systems available for you in combinations. First time we've seen all that with the Sony integrated chips. And check the show notes for a reduced price if we can get one for you. Thanks for watching. We don't usually do these kind of reviews, but if you like them, give us a thumbs up. Maybe we'll do some more where we get deeper into the technology to help you decide whether or not it's for you or not in your particular needs. Alrighty, we'll see you again soon. Take care.